Hey guys, what's going on? It's Eli back with another review video. And yes, as I mentioned in the last review, I basically couldn't think of a good way to hint what I was reviewing. But anyway, so yes, of course, continuing on reviewing the Marvel films, and we come back to another one of these featuring none other than the Punisher. That is Punisher Warzone. I can definitely tell with the Punisher films, they're very underrated, and they didn't, unfortunately, do so good.
The story. Frank Castle, aka the Punisher, this time being played by Ray Stevenson, turns the streets of New York City red as he wags a one-man war against the crime responsible for the death of his wife and two kids, aided by his trusted sidekick, McGroppy, played by Wayne Knight. He almost kills Bill Rosito, played by Dominic West, aka Jigsaw, and leaves him horribly disfigured, Billy renames himself Jigsaw, and with the help of his crazed brother, Looney Bin Jim, recruits criminals from every corner of the city to do battle with Frank. Yeah, so I thought this film was okay. I didn't hate it or anything, but definitely, when it got up to the third act, I was starting to get into it, yeah. I feel like as though that the third act, and when things were, getting intense, fighting and battle and so on, yeah, I feel like it was getting a bit better. And the thing is that, this was going to be a follow-up and a sequel to the 2004 Punisher film, and Thomas Jane would have, with Thomas Jane reprising the role of the Punisher himself, but fortunately he dropped out because he wasn't really liking, apparently he didn't really like the direction the script was taking and was going, and so basically I can tell, it's obvious, you can tell right away. If you would see the first Punisher film, and then you would watch this film, you can tell the difference between these two films. Obviously, they are not connected, and they're just two separate things, different adaptations of the comics, the Marvel comics of Punisher, basically. So, I have a point there. But the cast of characters, first off, the story, because I was trying to concentrate on the story because, at one point, Punisher accidentally kills one of the good guys, and even Wayne Knight's character tells him, his sidekick was kind of there to give him advice and helping him out, and even when Punisher was talking about, Frank Castle, Frank Castle, he goes by Punisher, Frank was talking about, he killed one of the good guys, and that being, it doesn't show the full last name, but, Nick is, being played by Romano Orzari, he got killed by Punisher accidentally, and Wayne Knight told Frank that he didn't know because, Nicky, he was one of the good guys. He was on the good side. And Nick had a wife and daughter, Angela, played by Julie Benz, and Grace, played by Stephanie, I don't even know how you pronounce that last name, I'm sorry. But they're all that's left, and, he survived, of his wife and daughter, And of course, Jigsaw, played by Dominic West. Okay, first off, I'll give Dominic West this. Both Ray Stevenson and Dominic West, I think these two were not that bad in this film. I found their performance as the good guy and the bad guy pretty good. Ray Stevenson, being the new Punisher after Thomas Jane, I think Ray Stevenson did pretty good as Frank Castle / Punisher. And as for Jigsaw, first off, they actually captured the likeness of Jigsaw pretty good. Even after watching the movie, I did a bit of research and seeing the images of Jigsaw in the comics, and yeah, and that's how he's supposed to look, because after he, he fell into, a system or something with broken glass, and it was messing his face up. He was bleeding and so on, and he undergoed surgery, the way he looks, I think they captured it, like how Jigsaw looks in the comics. I just like it after, he takes off the bandages and he looks himself in the mirror when he asks two of his henchmen, Pitsy, played by Mark Camacho, I think I said that right, and I think it's this guy, Ink, yeah, played by Kareem. That's his name, basically, the actor's name. When they go back into the room and, we see the reveal of his new face, Jigsaw. He killed the doctor that tried to help him. Well, that's the villain for you, Jigsaw. I kind of like it, because even when they call him by his real name, he tells them that he's dead and he now goes by Jigsaw. I was like, oh, that kind of reminds me of, say, I was saying to myself, that kind of reminds me of, like, say, in Batman, where, Jack Napier went by Joker now, because, Jack is dead, my friend, you can call me Joker, because technically, Joker, when Joker stepped in, Joker was a new person, you get my point. So, yeah, that's the thing, because when Dominic West's character becomes Jigsaw and with a new face, yeah, he totally changed his attitude, totally changed his personality. And he, especially, I could tell he's one of those villains that, could be kind of goofy and laugh and so on. So I think, yeah, Dominic West did pretty good. And hey, Wayne Knight, I think it's Wayne Knight, what's there not to like about Wayne Knight? He's a beloved actor and he's a funny guy, and yeah, he was pretty good in this, and again, like, giving advice and being a loyal, good sidekick to Frank Castle. So, even when, like, say, Punisher went to apologize to the wife and the daughter, I think, like, he wasn't saying that he was sorry. He kind of, I guess he said it in a different way, and he knew the fact that, her husband taught her about how to use a gun and so on, and he, like, moved it, she was aiming it at his head, but he moved it to his chest, also, like, some of the other, like, another, like, one of the, number one of the sidekicks of Punisher, Carlos Cruz, yeah, played by, well, the actor's actual name, first name is Carlos, Gonzalez, I think that's about right, Gonzalez. Also, there was also two FBI agents, Paul Budden, I think I said that right, played by Colin Salmon, and Martin Soap, they call him Soap in this, played by Dash Mihawk, yeah, sorry. I thought these two were pretty good, especially, at first, like, Paul was going to arrest Punisher, but I like how later on in the film and then later on in the third act, he was now, like, trusting Punisher, aka Frank Castle, helping, joining Punisher, that is. And I thought some of the action was pretty good, like, some of the violence in this, like, bloody and gory, like, a couple of times where Punisher shot, from shooting their heads, exploding, or, say, literally shooting someone, like, with a bazooka or something and literally exploding, yeah. Even when, say, at one point, Jigsaw's, like, henchmen, like, broke into, the house of of Angela and Grace. And even when, say, Paul came inside and, you know, he was put at gunpoint as well, and Punisher stepped in, and Paul, he was going to arrest one of them. Well, Punisher, he wasn't going to let that happen. He just, like, shot him and blew his head up. And, of course, Paul just, like, throwing a tantrum, like, you know, he's pissed off at Punisher because he was about to take him in. And Punisher, well, he killed him. So, well, obviously, for good reasons. Like, what was the point of throwing him in jail? Since, hey, he's part of Jigsaw's henchmen, say no. Also, another character that showed up earlier in the film, like at the beginning of the film, Caesar, played by John Dunhill. Yeah, because there was a meeting with both his character and Dominic West. So, this film did have a few funny moments, I should say. I laughed at a few moments. I chuckled, you know. And even, like, say, like, the way that the movie ends, like, okay, I do recall, because it's unfortunate, because, you know, Jigsaw has both Angela and Grace held hostage, but also Wayne Knight as well. Even when, say, oh yeah, earlier in the film, Punisher takes Angela and Grace to his hideout, and Grace, the daughter, opens up a chest sees a bunch of, like, items that obviously that belong to Frank Castle's kids. Even, like, say, was it a snow globe? You know, like a merry-go-round snow globe, and you turn it on and it would make music and so on. And, you know, and, like, Grace asks, you know, would, you know, because, oh yeah, Frank did mention Grace a little bit about his daughter, and Grace asked, you know, Frank, you know, she wouldn't mind me playing it, and, you know, Frank was like, no. So, and even, like, a bond, like, there was a bond between the little girl and Jigs and the Punisher. I almost said Jigsaw. Good God. And as I was saying, because both the mother and daughter are held hostage, as well as Wayne Knight's character. Even when, say, Carlos, who's, you know, another one of Punisher's sidekicks, came in and helped out and keeping, you know, protecting Angela and Grace, and even Carlos, like, you know, bonding with Grace. And too bad for Carlos, because he got killed by, you know, Jigsaw's brother. So and yeah, even, like, say that one scene where, you know, they Jigsaw breaks his brother out of an asylum, and yeah, that was a pretty interesting scene. And when, say, you know, his brother, you know, killed this one big fat guy, you know, like, coming in and kind of taunting him and was feeding him, so, you know, and God, his, you know, Jigsaw's brother just, Looney Bin Jim, played by Doug Hutchison, I think I said that right. Yeah, Looney Bin Jim just killing that guy and just, like, pulling his, like, was it his heart? I think so. And, yeah, and unfortunately, like, Wayne Knight's character doesn't make it. Like, even when, say, Punisher does kill one of the henchmen, and then, you know, Jigsaw kills Wayne Knight's character. And of course, you know, the mother and daughter, they survive, and Punisher beats up and defeats Jigsaw, you know, like, impaling him, you know, with a pole, and then, you know, finishing him off by putting him into a fiery pit, basically. What a way for Jigsaw to die. So, and the epilogue was pretty nice. Like, even when, say, Grace was saying goodbye to Punisher, and Angela said to Punisher that, you know, her husband talked about him, and, you know, her and him argued about Frank and how, you know, Frank was one of the good guys. So, and right before the movie ends, because Soap helps out Punisher and taking him out, like, you know, going to get him a drink, basically. But that's when, as Soap is talking, I was kind of, I was wondering, oh, is he gonna disappear? And yeah, he does. And at one point, Soap is gunpoint, give me your wallet. And, you know, he's like, Frank, and obviously Frank is not gone. You know, he was listening to what was happening, and we see, and up to, you know, behind Frank, a church, and with the lights, like kind of shorting out, and I think it said pieces, I think, yeah. And it cuts to black when, you know, Punisher, he pulls the trigger and kills, you know, the robber, like, you know, gun pointing at Soap. And what a way for right before the credits roll, Soap gets the last lines. Oh, now there's brains, you know, all over me. It was pretty funny, and what a way to end the film right there. But with all that being said, Punisher Warzone, I thought was okay. And gosh, I saw this, like, its score on Rotten Tomatoes, 29% is, yeah, 29%. Wow, it's obviously, it's really bad. In fact, I even read this that this is the lowest rating Marvel film, you know, out of any other Marvel film. So, but again, I thought it was okay, as I said before. And what about you guys? Have you ever seen Punisher Warzone? Did you think it was okay? What did you think of my review? Just leave comments and give this review a like, as always. And how do I rate this film? Well, that's a good question. And again, since I said I thought this film was okay, I mean, you know, I'll give it, it's on my mind, what the heck, I'm giving this a 6 out of 10. 6 out of 10 stars for Punisher Warzone. Anyways, I mean, again, I thought this was okay, an okay Marvel film, so. And actually, there was something else of Punisher where Thomas Jane did reprise the role, but it's like a short film or something. It's not a movie. Yeah. And even, you know, years later, we would get a Punisher series set in the MCU. So, yeah. But anyways, so again, 6 out of 10 stars for Punisher Warzone. I hope you guys enjoyed my review of Punisher Warzone. More reviews coming your way. They're gonna be awesome. Keep looking forward, and I'll see you guys in the next video/review. And stay tuned later this week. Of course, going back to the MCU, continuing on reviewing the MCU films, all Marvel, Thor is back, and this time, well, basically, yeah, you probably know what it is, Thor Ragnarok. Stay tuned, take care, and peace out.